alligators, waterfowl, and snakes in the Arthur R. Marshall Loxahatchee National Wildlife Refuge, along with South Florida farmers nearby, share the same water source, the refuge, which is a part of the Florida Everglades.
We are a national wildlife refuge, but we are also a water conservation area. And so one of our mission statements is to be able to supply water to the local municipalities.
This dual purpose often pits man versus wild during dry spells, ultimately to the detriment of the Everglades themselves, which is why the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers is building Phase 1 of the Site 1 Water Impoundment Project that will be maintained and operated by the South Florida Water Management District.
It's going to allow us to keep more water in the Loxahatchee National Wildlife Refuge than we can currently, especially in the dry season or during severe droughts.
Paid for in part with American Recovery and Reinvestment Act dollars, an area that was once slated to be a landfill will soon be essentially a 13,000-acre, 8-foot-deep lake that collects water from urban runoff during rainy periods, then releasing it for agricultural use during dry spells. The goal is to keep more water in the natural Everglades system, making the Site 1 project a contributor to the overall comprehensive Everglades restoration program.
It's one of the smaller ones, but a very key component nonetheless.
Bill Gore, with Lodge Construction, the general contractor on the project, estimates 50 jobs will be created over the 2-year construction cycle of Phase 1, but the Florida native also sees the Site 1 project as having a lasting impact on the region.
Projects like this are just great because it benefits the environment for lifetimes.
Phase 1 is expected to be completed around October of 2012. From the Loxahatchee National Wildlife Refuge, Patrick Bloodgood.